How did Magic Johnson contract HIV? In this video, we're going to take a deeper look at Magic Johnson's unrestricted bedroom behavior while uncovering facts and shocking revelations from the superstar's ex-lovers and friends which indicate that Magic Johnson may have contracted HIV after indulging in unprotected sex with other men. Stick around to the end and tell me how you think Magic Johnson contracted HIV after hearing all of the facts and evidence presented in this video. I'm your narrator E, and I welcome you to Big Talk TV. Now let's get into the facts about Magic Johnson. On November 7, 1991, NBA superstar Magic Johnson publicly announced that he was HIV positive. Immediately following this surprising news, gay accusations began plaguing his public image. For this reason, Johnson penned an article defending his sexuality in the November 18, 1991 issue of Sports Illustrated magazine. But defending his sexuality would prove to be a difficult task for Magic Johnson, since the rise of HIV and AIDS had already exposed closeted gay celebrities of the 1980s like Liberace, Rock Hudson, and former NFL player Jerry Smith. In his Sports Illustrated article, Johnson wrote, "By now, I'm sure that most of America has heard rumors that I am gay. Well, you can forget that. I sympathize with anyone who has to battle AIDS, regardless of his or her sexual preference, but I have never had a homosexual encounter. Never." In the days following the publication of Magic Johnson's article in Sports Illustrated, Johnson's close friend and fellow NBA superstar, Isiah Thomas, spoke with the New York Times. He warned the public against overreacting and making generalizations about Magic Johnson's sexuality. However, all was not well between the two friends in November of 91, when Isiah Thomas publicly supported Magic Johnson in the pages of the New York Times. In fact, Magic Johnson had long believed that Isiah Thomas told other NBA players, celebrities, and prominent members of the paparazzi that Magic Johnson was having sex with men long before Magic Johnson was diagnosed with HIV. For this reason, Magic Johnson sought revenge against Isiah Thomas. Magic details his revenge in the book When the Game Was Ours. As noted by ESPN commentator Jamil Hill, in the book, which Johnson co-authored with Larry Bird and frequent ESPN contributor Jackie McCollum, Johnson admits he helped keep Thomas off the 1992 U.S. Olympic Dream Team because he believed that his once dear friend spread a rumor that he was gay or bisexual. Interestingly enough, the plot that led to the exclusion of Isiah Thomas from the U.S. Olympic Dream Team occurred at least 2 months prior to Johnson being diagnosed with HIV. Why did Johnson respond so harshly to Isiah Thomas, one of his best friends? Was there some truth to the gay rumors? And why did rumors about Magic Johnson's sexuality predate his HIV diagnosis? Speaking on his HIV diagnosis with the LA Times in 1991, Johnson said, "I am certain that I was infected by having unprotected sex with a woman who has the virus. The problem is that I can't pinpoint the time, the place, or the woman. It's a matter of numbers. I confess that after I arrived in LA in 1979, I did my best to accommodate as many women as I could. Most of them through unprotected sex. Nevertheless, scientific data collected from the Center for Disease Control and PAS.com call into question Magic Johnson's claims that he contracted HIV after having unprotected sex with a woman. According to numbers collected from PAS.com, an HIV negative man has a 0.04% chance of contracting the virus from an HIV positive woman after unprotected sex. Additionally, CDC statistics from the year Magic Johnson was diagnosed with HIV show that heterosexual men who didn't shoot heroin or other drugs into their veins only accounted for about 1% of new HIV cases that year in 1991. With this information in mind, do you believe Magic Johnson to be one of the rare, almost non-existent cases of men who contracted HIV after having unprotected sex with a woman? Contradicting claims made by Magic Johnson in the press and federal court documents must also be scrutinized. In his autobiography, My Life, Johnson wrote, "Of the women I have talked to, nobody has tested positive for HIV. Thank God for that." However, federal court documents from the state of Michigan tell a different story. District Judge Richard Insland recounts facts which refute Johnson's autobiography. Plaintiff Waymer Moore alleges that defendant Irving Johnson Jr. wrongfully transmitted the HIV virus to her through consensual sexual contact. Ms. Moore alleges that the wrongful transmission of the HIV virus occurred on or about the evening of June 22, 1990, or the morning of June 23, 1990, or both, at her home in Ingham County, Michigan. Ms. Moore and Mr. Johnson had sexual contact, which allegedly led to the transmission of the HIV virus. Magic Johnson could not deny Ms. Moore's claims. In fact, as noted in the Associated Press, Johnson acknowledged having a sexual encounter with Ms. Moore. Moreover, Waymer claims she notified Magic Johnson of her HIV positive status in August of 1991, 3 months before he publicly announced he was HIV positive as well. Therefore, the claim that he knew no women who tested positive is false. If the words listed in Magic Johnson's own autobiography are not true, could the same also be said about his claims of not being involved in any homosexual activity? What do you think now that you've been presented with the facts and evidence from court documents, biographies, sports commentators, and the CDC? How do you think Magic Johnson contracted HIV?